years. Her cries at night, the neighbors took as beating for faults she must have committed. But when her attitude started changing and following cries of her younger sister, Cecile, some nights also, one neighbor turned self into an investigator. The kids confirmed the horrifying scenes at night. She went to the quarterhead at Polo Village, then the gendarmerie. Medical test confirmed rape, but the supposed accused, their 45-year-old father, Felix Mbele, meaning sorcerer in their village, refused. One investigation then led to the other. Question on the whereabouts of his wife, the mother of the two girls, he said he does not know. The gendarmerie, smelling foul, continued investigation. And Felix finally revealed he killed wife and buried her behind their home at Polo Village, Sa Central Region. Here, he replaced the scene that day with the wife. He started at squaring, then fight, and then he ended it all without any remorse. That is 6 years ago. Neighbors could never guess as they were notorious for quarreling and fighting every night. But he succeeded to convince the wife's family that their daughter has left him. The population is here in total shock, dismay and fear, especially of what he could have done to these children. Investigation still ongoing for justice to take its course. But the collaboration of the population highly saluted.
What a shocking report there. Now, a worker at a construction site has died and two others have sustained severe injuries after the collapse of an uncompleted building in Buda in West Region of Akamero. Now, the tragic incident has been blamed on incompetence, or rather has been blamed on negligence on the part of the owner, who is said to be in a haste to complete the structure before Christmas. More in the following report with student journalist on internship William Ford.
Goodwill persons attempt to save three workers following the collapse of this building. We are in Buda, precisely in the Tomika neighborhood, where negligence on the part of the owner reportedly led to this unfortunate incident. These incidents can be blamed on the owner of this building. He mounted pressure on the workers and wanted the building to be completed as fast as possible. In such construction projects, patience and time are required. But he said he is on a hurry and wants his house completed before Christmas. Normally, after constructing the first floor, we have to wait for about a month before continuing work. But we instead started 5 days after. Yet he did not end there. He wanted us to launch work for the second floor, basing ourselves on the instruments of the first floor, of which the first floor was not yet ready. That is how the building collapsed, when we were trying to remove tools maintaining the first floor for the second one. After calling on the intervention of experts in building constructions together with firefighters to rescue the workers, two of them sustained severe injuries and were taken to the Bafoussam Regional Hospital, while the other worker gave up the ghost on reaching the hospital.
The Minister of Decentralization and Local Development has been looking for a temporary building site to host the soon-to-be-set-up Regional Council for the Northwest Region of Akamero and other institutions that come along with it. Now, the choices seem to fall on the Regional Delegation for Tourism and Leisure and the residents of the military general commanding the 5th Combined Military Region in Bamenda. More in the following report with you, Chris Ekokobe, Remy Carroll, and Annie Collins. Annie.
In a bid to set up the last institutions of decentralization in Cameroon, the Minister of Decentralization and Local Development has been searching for an appropriate building to host the regional assembly in Bamenda for the Northwest region. On a one-day visit on Tuesday, George Elanga Obam has been on a marathon round of some structures. Guided by Governor Adolphe Lele Lafrique, he stopped over at the Delegation of Public Works, Secondary Education and Tourism and Leisure, which seems to be the favorite. Over at GRA, the residence of the general commanding the 5th Joint Military Region is tipped to host the Public Independence Conciliator, among other structures.
Find the building that can host the regional council. The governor and I went to down and visited five buildings.
The minister started and ended an upstation with two in-camera meetings with the administration and mayors, respectively.
I also have a very fruitful discussion with the mayors. We had consideration about the human resources, about the finances, about the savings status, and things like that.
We discuss many, many things concerning the functioning of the councils, especially the code that was put in place after the major national dialogue.
Many would have wished the minister descended downtown to see certain realities as the city accused the social media of telling lies about happenings in Bamenda.
Now, the German ambassador to Cameroon has signed a partnership agreement with Comifag worth more than 13 million euros. The sum is aimed at boosting forest reserves in Cameroon and other environmental sectors. Here now is an excerpt of the ambassador Corina Trix after the signing ceremony selected for us by our reporter Hyson Chia. Take a listen.
This project is an example for our policy agenda. In Germany, the environmental questions are very, very important for our government. And here I think in Cameroon and Central Africa, it's important to find the right balance between environment protection and giving a perspective to the population, because we have to win everywhere around the world the population for protecting the environment. It's a regional project, which is always also important, because the nature doesn't accept any borders. And I think there are two points very important: protect certain regions as heritage, and on the other side, organize the exploitation of the nature, of the forest, for instance, in a way which gives a chance also for future generations.
And in more environmental news, some prominent Cameroonian artists are championing calls for more concrete actions to be taken to save nature. Now, the likes of Mr. Liu, Onyema Laura, and Wax Day recently undertook a trip to the Kampoman National Park to see for themselves the work being done to save the gorilla habitat. The trip was coordinated by International Conservation Organization, the Worldwide Fund for Nature, WWF, as we in the following report.
Another thing too, we have to also remember that we don't show liquor, we don't speak, and if you want to sneeze.
And it was on these instructions from the field guide that these prominent Cameroonian artists, Mr. Liu, Onyema Laura, and Wax Day, took off for an adventure of a lifetime, a journey into the wildlife hotspot, the Kampoman National Park. Organized by the WWF Cameroon office, the visit aimed at making these champions of nature to touch base with the reality of the threat facing biodiversity. After hiking for hours, alas, the stars make their way into the park, and what a delight it was to watch gorillas live in their natural habitat.
You really want to be here. It's so beautiful out here. We're able to track the gorillas, and we're very fortunate to see some of them, although they were far up on the trees. But I mean, we got to see a few, and I felt so excited when some of them were trying to communicate with us.
For Mr. Liu, aka Lion of Africa, there is need for everyone to spread the word.
I, as an artist, the least I can do is talk to the people who listen to me that this is something worth preserving by all means possible. It doesn't matter who you are, you can always contribute in your own way.
Singer and songwriter Wadi, on his part, commended work put in to protect the gorilla habitat.
This Kampo National Park is just a small example of the amount of work that goes into making sure that these rich resources that we have are preserved. So it's been a wonderful experience just coming here to see the work that has been put into rehabilitating the gorillas.
The visit of these stars fall in line with WWF's ongoing campaign, dubbed the New Deal for Nature and People, which seeks to mobilize for concrete actions to be taken to stop biodiversity loss and put nature on the path to recovery by 2030.
Now, the National Order of Civil Engineering has cited competence, ethics and accountability as core values of the profession, which unfortunately are today not being respected as quacks have infiltrated the profession. Now, the Corps has been mobilizing people to promote these values as a kickstart celebration of the 20th anniversary of the National Order of Civil Engineering. As we end the following report with Beatrice Ngamo and Michelle Foucault.
It is commonplace to see persons involved in roads, buildings, tunnels, dams, water systems construction without any idea of how to go about them properly.
In Cameroon, everybody knows that you need to call an engineer if you want to realize a project. If it's not the case, you will have problem with quality, we will have problem with the respect of standards.
Professionalism is a concern of these civil engineers who have been trained to conceive, design, build, supervise, operate, construct and maintain these infrastructural projects and systems.
A risk analysis, risk control and risk management is very important. Some of the accidents that you've just mentioned sometimes may not necessarily be linked to the studies, sometimes may be linked to the execution of the project.
Nowadays, foreign engineers and contractors are into big projects which local or national engineers would have handled at low cost. The objective of the Civil Engineer Seminar opened Tuesday at the National Advanced School of Public Works.
It's a question for us to reinforce our capacities to be more professional in order that for the future it will be Cameroonian engineer who will be involved in the development of our country.
Competence, ethics, accountability and social commitment, key values of the civil engineering profession today. Time Cameroonians make use of their civil engineers, give professionalism the opportunity to offer its best for the development of this country.
And that was it for this edition of the Bilingual News. Thank you so much for watching. Bon après-midi, Robert.
Bon après-midi, Regina. Bon après-midi, mesdames et messieurs. Restez scotchés sur les antennes des Canal 2 International. Et à demain, s'il plaît, adieu.